This is Venkatramana. Today's class, 10th class physical science, first unit, reflection of light through spherical mirrors. We already completed regarding what is meant by reflection and what are spherical mirrors and how many types of spherical mirrors are there, what are they and what are the terminology which we will use in spherical mirrors. We already completed in previous classes. Now we will go for how to draw normals for the spherical mirrors. Now before going to that, let us brush up that loss of reflection. Now body have loss of reflection, loss of reflection. Now why we require loss of reflection, we will discuss now. Loss of reflection. Whenever any light ray falls on opaque body, it will bounce back to its original medium by following certain laws. Mainly three laws are there. Number one, angle of incidence will be equals to angle of reflection. Number two, incident ray, reflected ray and normal all will lies in same plane. Same plane. They won't lie in different plane. They will lie in same plane. If you have what you call this plane, soft surface, all incident ray will go come fall here. Reflected ray will come in this way, normal also will draw here only, at the same plane, not the other plane. The third one, very important, which is useful for the reflection through spherical mirrors, that is, incident ray and reflected ray will always lies on either side of the normal. Will always lies on either side of the normal, except one condition. Either side of the normal, except when incident ray incidents normally, except in that conditions, in remaining all conditions, the incident ray, if it is one side of the normal, reflected ray will be on other side of the normal. This principle we have to use to draw the, this law is useful to draw the reflected ray whenever we incident ray. On a spherical mirror. Now, how we will use that one? Let us see. Now, how to draw the normal? That means if you know the normal, then we can able to draw the reflector ray on other side of the normal, where incident ray incidents. That's why you should able to know how to draw normal. Now, how to draw normals for spherical mirrors? If it is a concave mirror, a curved outward surface is vortex. Then this is a pole. Let us assume this is the center of curvature. Then this is a principal axis. If it is a principal axis, then it will be a principal focus or focal point. Now let us draw one incident ray. Incident ray will fall like this, not in this way. It will come from in front of mirror and fall on the mirror at a point X. Then why are you draw normal? If you draw normal, then incident ray will be on one side of the normal, reflector ray will be on other side of the normal by following the second law of reflection, that is angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. That means at this point of incidence, we should be able to draw normal. Generally, for plane mirror, at this point of incidence, if you want to draw normal, simply will draw one perpendicular to that point. But since it is a curved surface, how to draw normal? That means let us draw one tangent. What is a tangent? A line which touches the circle at one point. Is known as a tangent. So we will draw a tangent at this point. Now since it is a plane, for this plane surface, let us draw one perpendicular. Now this is a perpendicular to this point, to this tangent. Now this will act as a normal. Then now we know that since incident ray is above the normal, reflected ray will be below the normal. In this way, we can able to draw the reflected ray by following angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. That means whenever any incident ray is drawn for the curved mirrors, spherical mirrors, you should be able to draw normal. Then you have to check whether incident ray is above the normal or below the normal, or on the right side or left side of the normal. Then we can automatically we can able to draw reflected ray on other side of the normal in which incident ray is not there. Now that means for spherical mirrors you should know how to draw the normals. Then every time you have to draw the tangent at the point of incidence, then you have to draw perpendicular, means it will be a huge complex system, means a complex process or lengthy process. So in order to make it easy, then we have a little bit activity which gives idea how we can able to draw normals for spherical mirrors easily, how we can able to draw normals for this concave mirror and convex mirror, from where you have to draw normals easily. That let us do a certain activity. Now what is that activity? We will take one plane surface. We will take one plane surface. This is a plane surface. Now let us take three pins are what you call three. This is what you called this needles. This is what you say nails. Now let me poke this nail. If you take pens, it's very good. Now if you take pens, we can able to very good. So these nails are visible to you? No. So let us bring the pens. Then we can able to see. Now what is this? It is acting as a normal. So instead of this nails, let us poke with this pen. Now it is clearly visible, I think so. So I will now. What is this? It's a plane surface. Now what is this? Now it is acting as a normal. Let me draw one more normal to the same plane surface. So I draw another normal for this plane surface. See, this is a plane surface. These are the normals. Let us take one more normal. Now what happened? This is a plane surface. This is a plane surface. For plane surface, I draw normal. Now let us make this plane surface as a curved surface. How? Let me make curve. What happened now? This duster I made in plane to curve. Duster I will make plane to curve. So what happened? Now it is acting as curved surface or not? It is acting as curved surface. This is a concave surface. Now what happened to the normals to the before we made into concave? This is a plane surface. These are the normal. Now what happened if I curve like this? All normals are converging at one point. That converging point you will call it as center. That means if you want to draw normal to the concave mirror at any point of incidence, you have to draw line from center. Then that will call it as a what you call normal. So for this concave surface, all normals are converging. But what about for convex surface? For convex surface, what happens to normal? Normals are not at all converging, they are diverging. That means for this convex surface, for this convex mirror, if you want to draw normal, so this is a point of incidence. Then how to draw normal at this point of incidence? It will be the center behind the mirror. Then you draw normal like this. If you draw one more incident ray, then how to draw normal at this point of incidence, which is a Y? You draw one normal from center. So let me draw one incident ray here for concave mirror. Then how to draw normal from center? You have to draw one line passing through that point of incidence. In this way, we can able to draw normals easily for concave mirror and convex mirror. But for convex mirror, all normals are diverging. They are diverging, all meeting at one point. And they are appearing that they are coming from a center. They are appearing that they are coming from a center. Whereas for concave mirror, all normals are convex. In this way, we can able to draw normals for concave mirror and also for convex mirror. Then, if we know the normals, how to draw normals, then it is easy to draw reflector ray for any incident ray. Now the question arises, how many types of incident rays are there? How to draw reflector rays for respect to incident ray? What does it mean? Suppose if I take one concave mirror, where bulged out or curved out surface, I will paint or coat. Now I will draw one principal axis, pole, center, focal point. Now for this concave mirror, this is the front of the object, this is the behind the object. Already we discussed that center and focal point are real for concave mirror, whereas for convex mirror, these are virtual. Means they not belong to the mirror because they will be behind the mirror. Now, how incident rays can fall from the object? Object will be in front of the mirror. Incident ray can fall on concave mirror parallel to principal axis. Then what about its reflector ray? Incident ray can pass through focus. Then what about its reflector ray? Incident ray can able to pass through center. Then what about its reflector ray? Incident ray can fall on pole. Then what about its reflected ray? Incident ray can move along the principal axis. Then what about its reflected ray? All incident rays are parallel and going on falling on this mirror, making certain angle with principal axis. Then what about the reflected rays? In this way, depending upon different incident rays, we'll have a different reflected rays. In order to what you call easily remember, that they called as a rules or what you call different situations for various incident rays for concave mirror. That means for so-and-so incident ray, what will be its reflected ray by the concave mirror and by the convex mirror. That we will call as situations or rules for various incident rays for concave mirror. So let us discuss that for now. What we are going to discuss now? Situations or rules for various incident rays by a concave mirror. Rules or situations. Situations for various incident rays. What is the incident ray? The ray which will come from source and fall on mirror for various incident rays for concave mirror. For concave mirror. Now, rule one or situation one. Rule one or situation one. So, what is the rule one? Let us draw one concave mirror. Curved out surface is painted or coated. Then let me draw one incident, principal axis. Let us mark one center and focus. What is the first rule? Means if incident ray is parallel to principal axis, then its reflected ray will pass through focus. This is incident ray. This is reflected ray. If incident ray is parallel to principal axis, reflected ray will pass through focus. That is rule one. Rule one. What is rule one? If incident ray is parallel to principal axis, reflector ray will pass us through principal focus or focal point. Now rule two. Rule two. Now what is rule two? Converse of first rule is called as rule two. Let me draw one more. What do you call it? This concave mirror. And obviously we have to shade for curved outward surface and draw principal axis in the mark center and focal point. Four. Then if incident ray only passes through focal point, if incident ray only passes through focal point or focus, then obviously reflector ray will be parallel to principal axis. Reflector ray will be parallel to principal axis. That is rule two. Now we will go for rule three. Rule three. Now what is rule three? Let us draw one concave mirror. Now we have to coat on curved outward surface. Then draw one principal axis, mark center and focal point and pole. Now if incident ray passes through center, if incident ray passes through center, now the question will arise, where is the normal? Already just what you called in last concept, we discussed that. Every normal will be drawn from center to the concave mirror. That means in this case, the incident ray and normal both will coincide each other. Incident ray and normal both will coincide each other. Means they will be on same line. Then angle of incidence will be zero. If angle of incidence is zero, what should be the angle of reflection according to laws of reflection? Angle of reflection should be zero. That means reflector ray will also be along the same path. That means reflector ray will retrace its path. In what way it will come in the same path, it will move back. So if incident ray falls on concave mirror passing through center, it will reflect back in the same path, or it will retrace its path. R-E-T-R-A-C-E-S, retraces its path. Now let me go for rule 4. Rule 4. Let us draw one concave mirror. Draw principal axis, mark center, focal point and pole. Now, testing that incident ray passes through principal axis, along the principal axis. That means you are now incident ray and the principal axis both are coinciding each other. If incident ray is along the principal axis, then how to draw normal? You draw from center to the P. That means every principal axis is a normal at P. Every principal axis is a normal at P. That point you have to remember. That means here, in this case also, incident ray and normal will both will coincide each other. When both coincide each other, then angle of incidence will be zero. Then what should be angle of reflection? Angle of reflection will also be zero. That means here also it will retraces its path. Simply in what way? Reflector will also move along the incident principal axis only. This is about rule 4. Now rule 5. Rule 5. Now what is the rule 5? Concave mirror, curved outward surface is painted or silvered. Draw the principal axis, mark center and focal point pole. If incident ray falls at P, if incident ray falls at P, then now the normal will be, principal axis will become normal and this will be angle of incidence. Then reflector ray will reflect on other side of the principal axis such that it makes same reflecting angle like incident angle with principal axis. That means If incident ray falls at P, then it will make certain incident angle with principal axis. With the same reflecting angle, reflector ray will reflect on the other side of principal axis, such that angle of incident and angle of reflection both are same. Both are same. In that way, we have a 5 rules for concave mirror. 5 rules for concave mirror. Now, in this way, let us summarize our rules for this concave mirror. First rule 1 is, if incident ray is parallel to principal axis, reflector ray will pass through focal point. If incident ray only passes through focal point, reflector ray will be parallel to principal axis. If incident ray passes through center, it will retrace its path. If incident ray is along the principal axis, it retraces its path along the principal axis. If incident ray falls at P such that it is making certain incident angle with the principal axis, reflector ray will be on the other side of the principal axis making same angle with principal axis. In that way, we have what you call is a 5 rules. 5 rules. So in this way, we have rules for concave mirror or situations for concave mirror. Now in this way, we have same rules for the convex mirror. Now these are the rules for the concave.